I'll sign up the vote if you take me to pick up the Subaru. Squirrels moved in and chewed up the wires again.
No problem.
All right. Come on, Darnell, you can sign up too.
I'm already registered to vote.
What?
Not that it matters, because until we reform the Electoral College, the popular votes will be ignored and we'll keep electing presidents that only get a minority of the vote.
That must be some black stuff. I don't know what he's talking about.
All I could afford was herself.
How's it going, lawyer lady?
Fruity, I need the damn dummy's guide. I swear it seems like half this legal stuff is written in Latin. Can't even understand the damn cartoons.
Well, this cartoon is easy. Obviously, the camel was suing for intentional tort because the turtle had prior knowledge that the rock was slippery and would cause physical injury, as well as deny him his liberty to cross the stream, therefore leaving the turtle liable.
Wrong. It's a llama, not a camel, stupid. I can't believe this. I'd have to go kiss that deaf lady's ass.
That's definitely a dromedary camel.
Troy, just give me my license.
Why? What's in it for me?
Well, you'd be doing a nice thing, which would get you two steps closer to heaven. And if I had to guess, you're probably a few steps closer to somewhere else.
Look, Earl, I'd love to give you your license back. But before I return it, I'm gonna need to see some form of identification. Some kind of picture ID. Perhaps a license.
You know, Joy, technically, that license is state property. It doesn't belong to either one of you.
Okay, Darnell, you're painting a turtle right now, and I'm not taking legal advice from you or any other turtle painter.
I'm just making them more visible. The kids keep stepping on them.
You want your license back. Well, I want something from you.
Fine, what do you want me to do?
I want you to fix that hole in the wall behind the Jesus-eating dinner picture that you put there.
The hole Joy was talking about dated back to a fight we'd had years before.
You cheating son of a bitch!
Back at the trailer park, Darnell was trying to patch things up too.
Look, baby, I fixed the wall.
That's for Earl to fix, not you.
If you don't want to slap each other, you can take turns kissing me.
Hey, Rodney, you're not a cop. Cops don't sell fake watches out of their trucks.
Damn, I thought that said coochie.
I'm gonna use this for hassling white people to make up for 300 years of racial injustice. Or maybe I'll just use it for Halloween.
Sorry, Darnell.
That's ours. But if it makes you feel any better, I'll use it to hassle some white people.
The hell makes you think you're gonna use it anymore?
Stupid cat is making my hands burn and my eyes water and my tongue starting to feel like it did when I ate all that pink cotton candy stuff in the attic.
You should take allergy medicine. I take it all the time. It relaxes me in social situations.
I tried that. It helped with the itching, but it made me a little bit too thirsty.
Chubby had always wanted to see Joy in a bikini, and he figured other people might like that too. And he was right. Had a bomb gone off in there that night, there wouldn't have been a straight man left in Camden.
God, that's a lot of people I know out there. What the hell is my guy to expect to see that he hasn't seen already? Man, why am I so nervous?
I don't know. You sure danced naked in front of us enough times. I mean, not at the same time.
Well, actually, there was that one time when I was hiding in the closet.
Wait, was that on Thanksgiving?
Yeah, we thought you
found it. I thought I heard something. First, I thought it was a squirrel. No, man, that is...
Hey, can you ladies please take your tea party outside? I need to calm my nerves.
How long were you in there?
It's a couple.
I would have stayed and talked through her stage fright, but it was clear Joy didn't need me.
This is not a truck. This is giant camper. Something is vicious. You are police, I know it.
Oh, calm down. I just gotta pick up the truck keys. So jumpy all of a sudden.
I just don't like surprises.
Surprise!
Throwing you a surprise birthday party.
My birthday is not until next month.
That's the surprise part.
Idiot.
It was Earl's idea.
Y'all are all idiots.
I think you should go talk to her.
Dumb dummy.
Yeah, that's not gonna happen.
Ah.
Arrow. Hey, Crabman.
What's Crabman doing here at his PJs?
Oh, he's in the witness protection program, and Joy found out because of the letter I delivered, and Darnell wouldn't tell Joy why he's in the program. So Joy threw him out, and I told him he could live here.
Fair enough. I'll ask for extra towels tomorrow.
Good night, Crabman.
Good night, Earl.
Is it the witness protection?
No. They're very polite. They usually hit my pager before they come over.
What about the people they're witness protecting you from?
I'd imagine they knock and then start shooting when they see me.
All right, you better hide then. Will?
Having a bad night, Earl. I heard Wendy still single, and I started to think, what if she...
Jake.
Hmm? Oh, I'm sorry. You're having a little private thing.
Oh, no. That's just my brother. We share a room.
They don't have rooms with two beds here?
They do, but not with a pool view. But look, it's not weird. We're family. Oh, right. That's our friend Darnell. He's spending the night. He's under the covers because, look, buddy, don't worry about Wendy. It's not like she's going to fall in love overnight. Love takes time.
When I fall for someone, it happens in an instant.
Your lover's right.
If she falls for someone, I could lose her forever. What am I gonna do if I lose her forever?
He could lose her forever, Earl.
I heard him,
I man. Can't lose her again.
He can't lose her again.
If I lose her forever, you'll never be able to cross me off your list. How are you gonna cross me off your list if she finds another guy?
I don't know.
Forgot about the list. What are you gonna do, Earl?
I don't know.
You have to know.
What are we gonna do, Earl?
Answer him, Earl.
I told you I don't know.
Earl. Why don't you just go down to the gym and keep an eye on Wendy until Will's ready to talk to her?
Oh.
Smart and handsome.
Earl thinks he's gonna find some silverware we stole a while back, but I stole it out money by Big Rock out back.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, kind of down, so it looks all black and gross, but underneath it's pure silver. It's kind of like my safety net. I like knowing it's there just in case I ever need to jump bail and head for Mexico to see a pair of shoes I like.
I didn't have the nerve to tell Joy that silver wasn't where she thought he was. You know a guy who graduated college at 14 is a virtuoso cellist who can identify 250s of G's, line these tests, but can't reveal any of that because he's in the witness protection program? Well, that's me. Don't tell anyone I told you this. My name is, well, you better just call me Crabman. When Mr. Fish died, I thought I'd bury him in the place he would like. It was a special place where I took Joy on our first date. Sorry, I thought the pepper was the fish food. I know that couldn't have been an easy way to go. But if it's any consolation, I put the fish food on my eggs. It didn't kill me, though. Sorry. You're gonna lighten up yourself. I don't need no friends. You're lighting up. It looked like it was from some ancient civilization, possibly Neolithic. It would appear to have been struck with cylindrical object that wouldn't have been invented until the Bronze Age. So I decided to take it down to the museum.
I thought I'd bring him in here since you're an expert.
I'm pretty sure it's just trash. But we still had a room in our display case.
Earl wasn't the only one who would never find the silver. Neither would Joy.
That's what they get for trying to screw with me.
And I sure wasn't going to be the one to tell her. I never say it out loud, but... That bitch is crazy.